Hello everyone, good morning to one and all. So, shall we do a quick revision of what we have learned in the last classes? Yes, so in the last class, we have started from understanding the diversity. So, you have learned how the diversity has been added on to our society and the meaning of the diversity, and also by taking the few example, how the human beings they will try to mingle with the other people, which is having a different identity, different principle, personality, as well as their thinking, as well as their tradition, etc., etc. We will see a lot of variety of people in your surrounding. Okay, so in the last class, you have understood how the diversity has been adding to our society, as well as how we are adjusting it, as well as how we are mingling with the people, each and everything you have learned in the last class. So I have told in the today's class we are going to learn about diversity in India. I am telling a one statement called India is a land of diversity. Yes, we speak different languages, we are having various types of food, we celebrate different festival, practice different religions, but actually, if you think about it, we do many things that are similar aspect, but we will do in a different way. So, our country is having a many kind of diversities, thousands of languages we have been speaking, different kinds of languages, and well as festivals we have been celebrating. Practicing different kinds of religion. Not only we are having Hinduism religion in India, we are having Buddhism, Jainism, Judaism, Islam religion, as well as Christianity, many like even Sikh religion. So different kinds of religions have been practiced in our country. But actually, if you think about it, some things are similar what other people will do, but that similar things only we will do in a different way. That is the characteristic of diversity. So, how do we explain diversity in a country? Okay, so little more than 200 years ago, along back before, train, aeroplane, bus, car become a part of our life. Yes or no? Without train, you can't imagine to travel from one place to another place. Without aeroplane also you can't able to travel from one place to another place within an hour, within a minute, and within a half an hour. Yes or no, children? Yes, a little more than 200 years ago, or along when these train, buses, transportation was been introduced, so it became a part of our life. So like that only diversity is also becoming a part of our life there. So people travel from one place to another place with the help of horse, camels, as well as on the barefoot, as well as ship, a long back ago. Often they went in the search of new land, new places to settle in, or for a people to trade with, and because it took a long to travel. So once a people got a place and they started staying there. Why the people were been traveling from one place to another place? Because where they are living, if it is affected by the famine as well as any kind of natural calamities, they were able to settle down in that area. So what they were doing, they were going to the new land, new places where they were getting the good climatic condition to settle down there. And also people were having on grace to invent, to discover different kinds of places. What are there in the world? What kind of places we have been there? So one craziness is there to advent, as well as to discover new places to settle down, as well as to do the work. Because of work also people used to travel from one place to another place. So these are the reasons behind why the people they were traveling from one place to another place. Some of the people leave their home because of famine, drought, what I have told, and that they were not getting enough food. So sometime as they began to make their homes in a new places, people began to change a little, and other they were managed to do the things in an old way. So their language, so the people, those were coming from a new place, from one place to another place. If they are coming, means not only they are just coming, even their culture, their tradition with them, it was settling in a new place there. Okay, so sometime they has began to make their home in a new places, because people began to change a little, or other times they managed to do the things in an old way. So their language, their food, music, religion became a mix of the old and a new. So that we call it as an intermixing of culture in a country. So even some cultures have been there which are been intermixed. Okay. From one culture to another culture, it has been mixed, because a lot of people, different kinds of people are living in that area. Means straight away the culture, the tradition will be mixed there. So the history of many places shows us how many different kinds of culture influences have helped to shape a life as well as culture of the people. So our history will tell about that one, how many different kinds of culture influences as well as influenced to shape our life as well as to shape our culture. So similarly, diversity also come about when a people adapt their life to a geographical area which they live, even geographical area in which area they were living. So according to that geographical area, their lifestyle condition is different, and their food habit is different. Their wearing clothes is also very much different there. So example, living near sea is quite different from living in the mountainous area. The people those are living in a sea area, it is quite different from living in a mountainous area. Both coastal area and the mountain area, if you see the both lifestyle, too much difference is there. So the people have a different clothing, eating habits, whatever work they are doing, according to that geographical area only, we will come to know what kind of different culture, tradition are being used in our country. So let us understand what we mean when we say that historical and geographical factors influence the diversity of a region by reading two different parts of our country, Kerala and Ladakh. Okay, I have told historical background as well as geographical area. They will influence more on diversity of that region, so that different kinds of whatever differences you are seeing from one place to another place because of that one only. So how it will influence on that one, how we will see the changes, the people those are living in that area and the people those are living in a coastal side area. What are their habits? What are their thinkings? Why their thinkings are so much different? So by understanding these two examples, you will come to know how a diversity, how the historical and the geographical factors influence on diversity there. Yes, you can see a table. One side I have written as a Ladakh, another side I have written as a Kerala. So Ladakh, it is situated in the northern part of Jammu and Kashmir, and very little in agriculture. Because it is a mountainous area, the little bit agricultural activities are being a little bit difficult to do in that area. So they does not receive any kind of highest rainfall, and totally it is covered with the snow. So for the livelihood, what they will do? The people keep the sheep and goat and produce the pashmina wool. It is a kind of wool which is getting from the sheep and the goat. They will remove the hairs from those animals, and that it will be, that hairs will be converted into the wools. That wool is very much famous in the Jammu and Kashmir. So that wool we call it as a pashmina wool. So pashmina shawls are very chiefly worn. That is the main occupation in the Kashmir there. Most of the people, they are engaged by making the pashmina shawls in the Kashmir. So what kind of food habit is there for them? They will eat meat and milk. So due to the mountainous area, Ladakh is not much attractive for the traders, so that they will come and settle down here and they will do the economic activities. So it was a trade route for them, where they've been coming from the outside country. So they had a passes through which the caravans traveled to what they called it today as this one, Tibet. Okay, so people will eat a milk and products like cheese and the butcher. Each family is having own goat, cows and dozens of yak. Being a desert did not mean that Ladakh did not attract its share of traders. It also considered a good trade route as had a many passes through which the caravans, the vehicles what they were traveling from outside the countries, they were entering to our country through this mountainous area only. So Ladakh, so with them they used to carry the textile, whatever garments they were having, spices, raw materials, raw silk as well as carpets. So they used to travel import and export through this route only. So Buddhism religion is reached Tibet via Ladakh through the Tibet only. The Buddhism religion was been introduced in the Ladakh. So Ladakh is also called as a little Tibet. Islam was introduced in this region more than 400 years ago. When the Arabs were traveling to our country, they used to pass the Ladakh route there. So as a result, those urban Arab people, they started introducing, influencing their religion on the people. So as a result, Islam as well as the Buddhism religion were been introduced in the Ladakh there. So Ladakh is very rich in old tradition song poem like local versions. Local songs are very much famous in the Ladakh. Tibetan national epic called Kesar Saga are performed or sung by the both Muslim and the Buddhist people. So in the Ladakh region, Kesar Saga, it is a national epic song of Tibet, which the people will sing there, and also they will do the some performance. Both the religion, Muslim religion as well as the Buddhist people, they will perform this song there. So this is all characteristics of Ladakh. Once again, I am going to tell, Ladakh is situated in the Jammu and Kashmir in the northern part, in the northern part of our country. So Ladakh is a desert in a mountainous in the eastern part of Jammu and Kashmir. It is situated in the eastern part of Jammu and Kashmir. At present, it is a union territory of our country at present. So I have told very little agriculture is possible here because it has been covered with the snow, and the rainfall, it receives very less rainfall, and we will see less trees are being grown in that area. So wherever it is possible to do the agriculture, they will do for their livelihood in the Ladakh. So the other occupation, the people used to keep the sheep and the goats and produce the pashmina wool. Pashmina wool is one of the famous wool which is available in the Kashmir there. So their food habit, they used to eat the meat, milk, cheese, butter, etc. So Ladakh did not attract its share of traders. They did not, because it is covered with a mountainous area. It was not an attractive place there. So many of the people, they have to pass this place to enter to our country. So the Arab people, Chinese, Tibetan people, they used to travel to this route with their products, and they used to sell in our market. And whatever products we will produce in our country, they used to take from here and they used to introduce in their part of their country. And in that way, the communication was been there. So whatever products they were bringing, it was being carried by the caravans, that is textile, spices, raw silk and the carpets they used to import and the export in the Ladakh there. So Ladakh is very much influenced by the two religion, called Buddhism and the Jainism. So Buddhism, it was reached via Tibet to Ladakh. So Ladakh is also called as a Little Tibet. So 400 years ago only the Islamic religion was been introduced, and we will see sufficient Muslim population in the Ladakh region there. So Ladakh is having very old tradition, and one national song, poems are been sung by their local people only. One of the famous song I have told as a Kesar Saga are performed, sung by the both Muslim and the Buddhist. So coming to the other part of our country, which is situated in the southern part, that is Kerala. So Kerala is a state in the southern western corner of India. It is surrounded by a sea. One side you can see the it has been surrounded by the sea, another side the hills. Okay, so in the Kerala they will grow spices like pepper, cloves and cardamom. So the land is so much of fertile, and it is having good climatic condition. For the traders, it was one of the attractive places, because the Kerala is, it is covered by the sea in the one side the hills, greenery is there, forest area has been there. So most of the people, they will like to travel in this kind of areas. Jewish and the Arab traders were the first to come to our country through the Kerala. So apostle of Christ, that is Saint Thomas, is believed to have come nearly 2000 years ago, and he has created bringing the Christianity to India. So the Saint Thomas, he was a Christian priest who came to the Kerala 2000 years ago. So he introduced the Christianity in the Kerala there. Many Arab traders came and settled down here. Portuguese also came and settled down here. How the Portuguese came, I will think about that one. How the Portuguese came means a person called Vasco da Gama. He discovered the sea route for our country 200 years ago or 300 years ago. Okay. From which route all kind of products they were traveling, they were exporting. So that trade route was being closed by some other kingdom in the other part of the world. So the Europeans, they were finding difficulty to communicate to our country, because a lot of demand was being there for our spices and whatever silk we are getting, and some products were being very much famous in the western part of our country, that too in Europe continent. So when they were finding so much difficulty, the kings in the European continent, they started giving encouragement to discover the new sea routes. So as a result, Portuguese, they also gave the much more contribution as well as support, encouragement to find the sea route for our country, because people were eager to communicate with us, to trade with us, whatever products we were producing. It was very much difficult to take to the western part of the country. So as a result, Vasco da Gama, by the encouragement of Portuguese king, he took the initiative step to discover the sea route for our country. He reached the Cape of Good Hope, which is situated in the South Africa, and afterwards he reached the Calicut, it is in Kerala. So from there the Portuguese started traveling from Europe continent to our country through that sea route only. So in this way, Portuguese, the Europeans also started settling in our country there. Ibn Battuta, he traveled here little less, and 700 years ago. So he wrote in his travel book, and he described about the lifestyle of Muslim people in the Kerala. So Portuguese discovered the sea route to India from the Europe when Vasco da Gama landed with his ship in the Kerala. Okay, so what kind of food habit they are having? Because I have told it is a fertile land. The farmers, they used to grow the rice. Because it is situated in the coastal area, the food habit, fish is very much famous in the seafood. Okay, instead of telling fish, seafood very famous in the Kerala, and people eat a lot of vegetables. And coconut is also famous in Kerala. Okay, so food habit, the people used to eat rice, fish and vegetables. So different kinds of people called Ibn Battut and Vasco da Gama wrote about Kerala and about our country, what they have seen in there. So some utensils are being used by the Kerala people. Okay, like fishing net. What kind of fishing net they were using? It was same looking like a Chinese fishing net. So that Chinese fishing net was called in the name of Chena Vela. And utensils, that is Bhande and Thiratral, Kannadaga. So utensils means the vessels what you are using for frying the vegetables for cooking. Okay, so that utensils was called in the name of Chena Chatti, which was used in the Chinese there. So we will, by seeing that, we will come to know even Chinese were also influenced on the Kerala people. So what kind of religion were being present in the Kerala was Judaism, Buddhism, Islam, Christianity, Hinduism, etc. We will see the different kinds of religions are being situated here. So boat race is very much famous in the Kerala, which is celebrated during the period of Onam festival. And it is one of the famous festival which is celebrated in Kerala there. So, based on geographical and historical condition, geographical area and historical area, we will see the difference between Ladakh and Kerala. Okay, so in the next class, I am going to tell about the comparison of Ladakh and Kerala and about unity in diversity, and then the lesson will come to an end. So in the next class, I am going to continue. So just you have to understand how the geographical and historical area, they very much influenced on the diversity in our country. So I have taken the example of Ladakh and Kerala. So if you are having any kind of doubt, just pin your question in the group so that I will try my level best to sort out your problem. So signing out, have a great day. Bye everyone.